Hi there, I'm Chris Berman. Here we go on ESPN. We'll see a real impact player from the defensive end spot, Pro Bowler Dwight Freeney, as he and his mates look to press the issue in this one. San Diego Chargers, Kansas City Chiefs, next!
And look at all the happy tailgaters as they get set to cheer for the hometown team. Hello and welcome to Arrowhead Stadium. I'm Dan Stevens. My partner in crime is Peter O'Keefe. And Peter, this game could boil down to a battle between two outstanding quarterbacks.
Absolutely, Dan. These guys put both their teams in a position to win every night. And this is the type of matchup that true football fans wait all year for. Phillip Rivers is a superb quarterback. His arm strength is just awesome. Defenses have to stay honest on the deep fades because he can deliver a deep strike at any moment. On the other side of the ball, we've got another top performer. Smith is a superb player. His versatility is what strikes me. He understands the game of football and knows how to make the most of his physical abilities in every situation.
Well, all right, Peter, we'll keep our eye on them as the game progresses, but first, the coin toss.
Heads. Heads it is.
We'll receive.
Number six, kicking off for the Chiefs.
There's the signal, and
it's
we're ready.
For Chiefs football.
Number six kicks it off to begin the game. Number 39 catches it back at the one. Dodges a tackle, brought down at the 25.
Number 39 received that nice kick and a nice little run back after the catch. Good job.
The Chargers will start this drive at their own 25-yard line. Brown goes in motion. Boyle takes a tough catch and tries to get free. Finally dropped at the 37. First down.
Phillip Rivers makes a terrific completion in double coverage here. Wow, now that is one confident QB.
A well-designed play there, Peter, and they will move the chains.
And let me tell you, Dan, hearing those chains move is one of the best sounds in the game for an offense.
Matthews takes his first carry of the game and shoots forward for 9 yards.
Matthews played smart and used his blockers to perfection on that last play.
Peter, what a nice pickup to get them into a second and short situation.
Yeah, great play, and now they have a bunch of options on what to try next.
Second down, 1 yard to go. Matthews will get stopped at the line, and that will bring up third down.
Johnson made the save, dropping the ball carrier before he could get to the markers.
They hold pretty firm there, and they've got to do it again on third and short. Johnson takes it across the line of scrimmage and...
Okay, bring him out. Bring him out. You got the chains.
No first, baby. No first. No first, baby. No first.
Right down, baby. Woo! Yeah, baby. That's how we get it.
First and 10.
Matthews picks up about two, and that brings up second down.
Matthews used the blocking, but this stingy defense didn't give up much at all on that last play.
Not much there. It'll be second down.
Got to take what you can get, Dan, but they were, you know, hoping for more.
Matthews gets the call again and maybe picks up one on the play.
Matthews used the blocking, but this stingy defense didn't give up much at all on that last play.
Well, not much of a game there, and they will face third down.
Third and long, too, Dan. Big play coming up. Well, Dan, we got an empty backfield, five receivers, and the defense is in their dime. Let's watch.
Floyd goes in motion. This pass will fall harmlessly to the ground, and it's incomplete. It'll be fourth down. Seffries gets ready to punt this away. Seffries gets the snap and punts it away. Thomas fields the punt at the 10. Tackled at the 18.
Thomas racked up a few yards on the run back there, whittling down the size of the punt a little bit.
The Chiefs' offense will start this drive at their own 18-yard line. Number 82 didn't haul that one in, and it falls incomplete.
Number 82 had some room on the outside on that play, but catching the ball was a different story. Incomplete.
That falls incomplete, but it would have been a minimal gain had they completed it anyway. Smith unloads this one to the left, and the reception's made at the 36. Finally stopped at the 38. That will bring up first down.
Dan, bunch of receivers out there. Defense is expecting that, and they go to nickel.
Charles is at the 50. Finally popped out of bounds at the 48. It will be first down.
Charles gets aggressive here. Ow, nice stiff arm.
And Peter, this is just a great individual effort to slip this tackle right here.
Yeah, and it sounds funny to say this, but sometimes it's good to run with a bit of fear in you. You know, when you're afraid to go down, you can find your way out of tackles like that.
That will end the first quarter, and it's still a scoreless game. First down, three wideouts in the game. Smith throws a beauty to the right side. And the catch is made well past the markers for a first down.
Number 82 had three guys covering him on this play, and he still made the catch. I don't know if it was a good effort by him or a bad one by the defense. It could have been both. Oh, it's hard to believe that play worked.
Number 17 hauls it in right side and gets past the markers for a first down.
Number 17 makes the catch with three defenders on his case.
I just don't know why the throw was made in the triple coverage.
Hey, it worked.
Yes, it did. Smith throws a bullet and the reception's made at the 6. And he's in for the touchdown.
Number 82 makes the catch, but that's not enough for him. He gets it and takes off for more.
That's his first touchdown of the day.
And I think he's a guy you can count on to make those end zone catches. He sets a high standard for himself, and he usually meets it.
Number 6 to attempt the extra point. Murray holding.
Here's the extra point, and it's good. The ref gets the signal, and we're set. Number 6 rockets this one deep. Number 39 downs this in the end zone for a touchback. The Chargers offense comes out and has an opportunity to tie it before halftime. They'll start at their own 20-yard line. Royal goes in motion. Brown pulls the log down, and he's got the first down and a whole lot more.
Brown faces down two defenders and comes away with the football. Oh, nice catch.
A beautiful pickup, Peter. Everyone on the offense is happy about that play.
Definitely. Great call by the offensive coordinator.
And it will be a first down. Matthews takes it for his fifth carry and heads out right. Tackled, and the clock will continue to run.
Reinhardt used every ounce of his big self to do some key blocking on that last play.
They move the ball, and it will be second down. Second down, and they line up with three tight ends. Matthews gets the call again and takes it upfield. Pushed out at the 43. That will bring up first down.
First down, Chargers.
Matthews lowered his shoulder to make the play here. That's how you break through a tackle, baby.
Peter, those were some nifty moves to get free.
In that matchup, he doesn't even need to dig down that deep to pull it off.
Watch the pass, defense! Watch the pass!
Ball at the 43.
Rivers puts his arm into this one, and it's tipped! Incomplete.
Houston came in and got a hand on that football and left no chance for a reception there.
That had potential for some yards, Peter, but the defense was on top of it and shut it down.
Good denial there.
Second down coming up. Second down, both wideouts to the right. Brown makes the nice catch and is well past the markers for a first down.
First and 10.
Matthews gains 3 yards, and that will bring up second down. Second down, one man back. Royal catches the bullet out left and is at the 10. Touchdown!
Royal is going to make the catch. Right there, but that's only the beginning. Look at him chew up the yardage.
He gets the touchdown off a nice play. Fantastic athleticism.
What a player.
Step it up, defense. Step it up.
Number four, holding.
Now the extra point, and it's good.
Woohoo! Yeah. What'd I tell you? All day. Yeah. All day, me, all day. Come on now.
Number 9, kicking off for the Chargers.
The ref gets the signal, and we're set. Number 9, booms a beauty here. Davis decides to take it out of the end zone. Tackled at the 18.
Davis got out close to the 20 on that one, so his decision to take it out of the end zone didn't really pay off, but it didn't really hurt him either.
The Chiefs had an effective first drive, and we'll see if they can keep it up. They'll start at their own 18-yard line. Sherman goes in motion. Charles will get the carry on first down and gains about 3 yards.
Okay, let's go.
Second down and four wideouts in the game. Number 50 makes a play on this and forces the incompletion.
Number 50 came in and got a hand on that football and left no chance for a reception there.
Step it up, D! Step it up!
Single back!
Check three!
Smith throws a bullet to the flat and he connects at the 19. Stopped at the 24. Williams with the tackle. So that'll bring the first half of football to a close as the clubs head to the locker room all tied. And now let's send you to Chris Berman in our studios in Bristol for the ESPN Halftime Report. Boomer?
Okay, Dana, we'll get back to you guys in a moment. Welcome, everybody, to the ESPN Halftime Show. I'm Chris Berman. The Chiefs, therefore, find themselves in a tight ball game. Anything can happen in the second half. Not much action early on, so we'll pick it up early in the second quarter. Number 11 connected with his man on this one. A 17-yard touchdown for the Chiefs. The Chiefs strike first and go up by 7. The Bolt trying to answer back. The Chargers with possession at the 22-yard line. Number 11 ran a terrific route here and was able to pull this one in. A 22-yard touchdown for the Chargers. And that's where we'll leave this one. Chiefs are keeping it evened up. We're tied 7-all. Today's halftime hero has turned in an incredible performance thus far. Number 82 has taken over this game. And now let's return to the second half with Dan Stevens and Peter O'Keefe.
Thanks, Chris. And today's game has been presented in ESPN Game Sound, designed and developed in collaboration with Dolby, the leader in surround sound technology. The Chiefs get the ball first to start the second half, and they will have a chance to break the deadlock. It's all tied up here. Let's get down to the field and the action. Number 9 kicks it off to begin the second half. Williams downs this in the end zone for a touchback.
That's what I'm talking about, baby. Yeah. That's good work out there,
all right,
man.
All right, yeah.
The Chiefs have been locked in a defensive struggle so far. They will start this drive at their own 20-yard line. Smith unloads this one to the left, and the catch is made well past the markers for a first down.
Number 17 shows his coverage man the finer points of pass patterns, namely, get away from me. I have the ball to catch.
He really beat his man. That was bad coverage.
Yeah, he's just a great receiver, though. He knew where he had to be, and he was there.
A well-designed play there, Peter, and he removed the chains.
And let me tell you, Dan, hearing those chains move is one of the best sounds in the game for an offense.
Charles carries it for the third time and heads out right. Dragged down at the 45. Charles will take the handoff and heads left. Dragged down at the 49.
Jared Johnson brought down the ball carrier before the markers. There was some gain there, but not enough for the first.
They don't allow them to convert, but they did allow them to get very close.
Third and short. Let's see if they can come up with another big stand.
Number 80 catches it left sideline, and they convert on third down. It looks like, we've had an injury down on the field. As soon as we hear anything, we'll be sure to pass the information along to you.
Watch the pass, watch the pass.
First and 10. Ball at the 33.
Larry. Single back.
Charles picks up a yard on the play, and that will bring up second down.
Charles used the blocking, but this stingy defense didn't give up much at all on that last play.
Not much there. It'll be second down.
Got to take what you can get, Dan, but they were, hoping for more.
Intercepted. No one in front of him runs out of bounds at the 41.
Butler not only shanghais the football for the interception, but watch. Gets a few more after the catch. Great play all around. To react, make the catch, and then get some yardage to boot, You can't coach that.
Boy, that was a heads-up play to come away with his first interception of the game.
Yeah, you gotta love D like that.
The Chargers are going to try and capitalize on the interception. They'll start this drive at their 41-yard line.
Rivers
zings it to the right side, and it's intercepted. Touchdown at the 49.
First down.
Number 76 is going to keep his wits about him here and make a smart play. The ball's loose, but now he gains control. Good reflexes to recover from that bad play.
Matthews has his number called on first down and rambles for about five.
Okay, guys, we've covered this before. You know the plan. You know what to do. Let's stick to the plan.
Here comes the counter. Here comes
second
the counter.
And five. Three, ball up to 46 yards.
Allen goes in motion. Matthews punches this one left of center and maybe picks up one on the play.
Matthews stuck close to his blockers, but the play folded quicker than an over-caffeinated origami artist.
Third down with a split backfield. The receiver and forces him to drop the ball. Incomplete. That will bring up fourth down. Yeah. Siffries lines up for the punt.
Number one to make the return.
Siffries takes the snap and punts it away. The Chiefs let it bounce out of bounds at the two.
Mike Siffries finds the old coffin corner, as they like to say. Heck, I like to say it too. Out of bounds, and that's perfect. Buried them inside the 5-yard line.
The Chiefs offense takes the field with time winding down. They'll start at their own 2-yard line. Charles picks up about two, and that brings up second down.
Charles had blockers on his side on that last play, but the defense was too smart. It gave him nowhere to go.
Not much there. It'll be second down.
Got to take what you can get, Dan, but they were, you know, hoping for more.
So three quarters in the books now, and we're all tied. Second down, 8 yards to go.
Lay down.
Third and seven. Ball at the Chiefs, 5 yards.
Coach Schottenheimer is not happy with that call, and he's going to challenge it.
Hey, we want a challenge.
San Diego is challenging the spot of the ball.
This is their first challenge of the game, and even if they lose this one, they still have one challenge left.
As we watch the replay here, look for where the ball is when he's tackled. Remember, all he needs is one knee to be down.
After review, the call on the field is overturned. San Diego will not be charged a timeout. Fourth down.
He likes the call, and you sort of have a feeling that he knew it all along. Number two lines up deep in his own territory to punt it away.
To make the return.
Number two gets the ball and pummels this one deep. Allen gets it at the 40. Stopped at the 48.
Allen returned for a few there, but after that gigantic punt, it was like tearing a single page out of War and Peace. It doesn't make much of a dent.
The Chargers had a three and out last time. We'll see what they can do here. They'll start at the 48-yard line.
Second and five.
Leopard.
Ball at 43.
Brown goes in motion. It looks like, we've had an injury down on the field. As soon as we hear anything, we'll be sure to pass the information along to you. Third down from the shotgun. Clemens unloads this to the right sideline, and the catch is made for the first. The clock continues to tick down.
Antonio Gates took on triple coverage and came away with a phenomenal catch.
That is only his first catch of the game, believe it or not, and it took all the way into the fourth quarter to get it. Pretty unusual to not call his name for this long.
It is, and he's surprised it took this long as well. He loves to see the ball coming his way.
Rips him down in the backfield, and that will take them out of field goal range. Second down, three wideouts in the game. Clemens rifles it on the left side, and he connects at the 20. The Chiefs take their first timeout. First down, the clock is stopped at 1:10. Adams takes it for his 11th. The Chiefs will take a timeout. That's their second. Second down, and this is the 7th play of the drive. Johnson, the Chiefs take a timeout. That's their final one.
Third down.
That's negative yards for you, Green. Double tight wing left.
Matthews takes it off the toss and heads upfield. Tackled, and the clock will continue to run. Barry will be credited with the tackle. Fourth down coming up. Fourth down, and the field goal unit is on the field. Number 9 from 30 yards out and barely misses this one off to the right.
Number 9 misses the field goal here. Let's watch this again. Yep, it's just a little bit to the side of the upright, but close only counts in horseshoes.
The Chiefs start this drive of the game from well in their own territory, and the clock at 25. Number 82 snags the dart right sideline, and he's got the first. The clock continues to tick down. Smith spikes the ball, and that will stop the clock. Second down. The clock is stopped at 11.
Ball at the Chiefs, 32-yard line.
Richard, Richard, Richard.
Charles catches it in the flat, and the clock continues to wind down. So that'll do it for regulation time. We're going to need overtime to decide a winner in this one. It's heads.
Third down.
There's the signal, and we're ready. Number 9 kicks it off to begin overtime. Davis decides to take it out of the end zone. Tackled at the 22. Well, Peter, some interesting information up on the screen.
Oh, you bet. Not a lot of action in this one overall, but even though they're in good shape, a single score can turn it around. They have to stay focused here. Davis took it out of the end zone, and while it may have been a little risky, he gets out close to the 20, so it all comes out in the wash on that play.
The Chiefs get their offense on the field and will start this drive at their own 22-yard line. No dice, and it falls incomplete.
Marshall was on that fly ball on that last play like glue, and he knew where the pass was going, and he stopped it. Incomplete.
That had potential for some yards, Peter, but the defense was on top of it and shut it down.
Good denial there.
Second down coming up. Sherman goes in motion. Charles gains 5 on the play, and that brings up third down. Third down, 4 yards to go. They couldn't connect on this one. Incomplete. That will bring up fourth down.
Charles dropped the ball so fast there, you'd think it bit him on the thumb or something.
That's his first drop of the game, and while every drop does hurt, you can't throw too much blame on him for that one.
That would have been a tough catch.
Number 2 lines up to punt after the 3 and out. Number 2 takes the long snap and punts it away. Allen fields the punt at the 30. Locked down at the 41.
Allen racked up a few yards on the run back there, whittling down the size of the punt a little bit.
The Chargers had their last drive stall out at the end. We'll see if they can keep momentum throughout this one, which starts at their 41-yard line. Matthews gets the ball and heads out right, tackled at the 49.
Matthews has been taken to both outside and inside the tackles, but the D is not letting him get too free. So far, he's had to work hard to get 50 yards on 13 carries.
Second down, just a single receiver on the field.
Wow, those are nice stats. Way to carry the ball.
Johnson goes in motion. Matthews is at the 40, eventually shoved out at the 38. It will be first down. Matthews carries it off the toss and moves forward for 7.
Matthews played smart and used his blockers to perfection on that last play.
He gets another call, and he's carried the offense on his shoulders for these last 3 plays.
Hey, until it stops working, there's no reason to look elsewhere.
Second down, 2 tight ends in the game. Rivers dumps it out left, and it's complete at the 22. tackled hard at the 21. First down.
Chargers. Antonio Gates
took on triple coverage and came away with a phenomenal catch.
A well-designed play there, Peter, and they will move the chains.
Great execution.
Matthews gets the call on first down and only gets back to the line of scrimmage.
Number 29 with the tackle.
Second down, two wideouts on the field. Matthews picks up a yard on the play, and that will bring up third down.
Matthews used the blocking, but this stingy defense didn't give up much at all on that last play.
Well, not much of a game there, and they will face third down.
Third and long, too, Dan. Big play coming up.
Royal catches the heater left sideline, and they get the first on third and long.
The field goal unit takes the field. I know this game is unpredictable, but come on, guys. You still have got a chance to put it in.
Number 9 from 19 yards, and they take the lead.
Number 9 puts in an easy short one. A clean kick, no worries.
And that is going to do it for this one. The Chargers come out on top 10-7. For my partner, Peter O'Keefe, this is Dan Stevens saying goodbye until next time.
All right, Dan, thank you. So this one is in the books as we welcome you all to our ESPN Video Games post-game show. I'm Chris Berman. The Chargers stepped it up for sure, putting up some good numbers. We'll pick up the action midway through the third quarter. Number 56 shows some great awareness here as he gets himself into position to pick this one off. The ball at the 36, number 10, would drop back and deliver a strike on this one. Game tied, 7-all. Phillip Rivers would find his target on this one. And that's where we'll leave this one. Bolts edge out a win, 10-7. Now let's check in with our player of the game, a guy who made one big-time catch after another to help seal the win for his team. Number 11 is down on the field with Susie Colbert. Suze?
Thanks, Chris. You gave an outstanding effort. You may have the ingredient your team needed to pull out a win here. What made the difference for you guys to come out triumphant today?
Yeah, to be honest, you know, we just came together as a team real well today. My teammates all helped me out a lot, and I'm playing with a great cast of characters alongside me. I'm just happy to get the W, and now we've got to move on and look ahead.
Chris, back to you.
That concludes our presentation of the NFL preseason on ESPN, celebrating its 25th anniversary.